CEMADONTV. CEMADONTV. CEMADONTV.
Father, we dedicate this night to you for your glory. Absolutely for your glory, for your honor, for your worship. We celebrate because you are who is who. The I am that I am. The God who can make things happen. No one can challenge you. Your name is healing. Your name is power. Your name is deliverance. We worship you for what you are doing in our lives. We exalt your holy name for what you are doing in our families. Thank you for your patience. Thank you for your kindness. They encompass us, they encompass us about. In your name we crush them. Oh, Father, we give you praise. Father, we thank you. We need you more. We desire you. Speak your word into our beings. Speak your word into our lives. Speak your word into us. Your word is powerful. Your word is glorious.
Oh,
world was with God, and the world is God, and the world became flesh. Power is in the world. This is the world of God. I celebrate the word of God because the word of God is power. I celebrate the word of God because the word of God made the universe. So much power in the word. The word can set the whole place ablaze. The word can change your mentality. The word of God can change your garment. Oh, the word of God. Oh, the word of God. I need you, O word of God. I celebrate you, word of God. He said the word and heal my diseases. If my word is in you, says Jesus, whatever you ask, you have it. No child of God is permitted to lack the word of God. You are supposed to be enjoying the overflow of the word of God. The Lord said to Joshua, do not allow this word to be out of you. Meditate on it. Eat it every day, and you will prosper in the land. Oh, speak your word upon me, Lord. Speak your word and revive me. The Lord said to Ezekiel, prophesy. Speak my word. Even the dry bones will come back again. Oh, so no, Kariaba. Let us see. Let us see. Lift your hands as we sing this song. As we sing this song, let the word of God fall like dew upon your spirit.
Oh,
If you are to rate what I have seen in the ministry which I am in, actually the ministry which the Lord laid into my hands started even before I became a priest. While we were in seminary. And even as a reverend, I was already doing that at Bodija. So, I'm disappointed. I'm speaking from my heart. I'm highly disappointed with what I have seen. And I'm so happy with the theme of your program. The theme touched me so much, and I took it upon myself to blow it all over the world in all my social media networks. Great revival. If there's anything we need in the church today, we need great revival. A lot is happening. A lot has happened. The Bible says there's an error in the world where the people of God, you and I, people who are of the kingdom of God, are living the humanized life. People who don't believe in God are in charge. People who believe in God are not in charge. People who believe in God are tenants. People don't believe in God are lords. The Bible says it is an error. The reason is that the church lacks revival. We don't have much today, but we dwell not on it tomorrow. And let the main time and not carried away by the Spirit. My Spirit is under my control. I'm not the moon. I'm not being tomorrow. It takes knowledge to allow yourself to obey the Spirit of God. Because if you are in the place, you say, 10 minutes from Mass. And it was, do it that way, but God will do it so. Praise Christ. And say the question, what is happening to us? Where is our glory? Where is the power that should be in church? I'm telling the truth. If you draw out the map of Ikeja here, and then look at all the assets in Ikeja here, and then you divide it a word, the one that belongs to those who are serving God in spirit and in truth, go this way. And the one that not to those who are not serving God is but to show this way, you will be amazed what you will see. You will be amazed of what you will see. You will realize that I don't know if my God is even happy with us. We gather to worship Him and not in this house. The charismatic revival renewal group is destined to revive the church. But I don't know what is happening to us. We have allowed many things to eat us up. The devil is so clever. We fought the devil many years ago, but unfortunately, he discovered our weaknesses and he has penetrated into the reviving power, and the reviving power is taking. So painful. And then, even with some of us priests, including me, whom the Lord has raised, to step up the spirit of the revival into the church. The church is discovering so many errors in us. We don't want to believe in us again. Because we are scattered away by things that go wrong. Maybe fame, popularity, and even when the church wants to pay us. We fall out to perform our own churches. When those who are supposed to revive the church goes out of the church and goes out to the church is not revived. We can never revive the church from outside. The church can be revived from within. I realize what is the problem with us. That's what I want to share with you. From the passage we just read, you can see what Jesus Christ said. You heard it? Talking about two kinds of foundations. And I must tell you, without any fear of contradiction, that the majority of us, the devil, I was telling you yesterday that the devil has left Goliath and is now an ant. That ant has fallen sugar that does not even bite. That is an ant. I don't know if the devil died. Let me tell you, friends in Christ, majority of the problems we are having, why you are serving God in spirit and in truth, but people who are not serving God and controlling you, is because of your foundation. Today I want to journey back home. Let's go back to the village. Let's go back to our early beginning. Let us go back. Our God is the God of the Alpha and the Omega. So He's not the God of Omega only. He's the God of the Alpha, beginning. You don't joke with your beginning. I don't joke with the beginning of my ministry of my life. He is the God of beginning. Let's go back to the beginning for God's sake. On a seventh line, it's not worth living. You cannot examine yourself and ask yourself some fundamental questions. Jesus just gave this revelation and said, hey, if you build your foundation on or your house on a wrong foundation, it will collapse. What a mighty fall. Many of us have fallen. Many of us are about to fall. Many of us have cracked because the foundation is faulty. There are things I want to quickly tell you about foundation. Number one, foundation carries the weight of building. So what is it that is carrying you? Foundation. It is your foundation that is carrying you. As beautiful as this church is, what is carrying this church is the foundation. Foundation carries the building. Foundation carries the structure. Your life is being carried by your foundation. That is number one. Number two, the weight of load that you carry is based on the strength of the foundation. The weight of what you call blessings, the kind of blessings you desire, the kind of blessings you look for, is based on how strong your foundation is. Therefore, if your foundation is the foundation of one-story building, and because it suddenly came across wet, you want to change it to 21, it will collapse. If I ask you a question now, how strong is your foundation? You may begin to say, what do I mean? I will explain to you. The strength of the foundation determines the load it carries. Therefore, if you desire to be great, you desire to be great, you desire to be great, then you must have great foundation. You desire to be mighty in your community, to make impact in your community, you want to take charge of that business in that location, then you must have a solid foundation. You want your marriage to be a wonderful marriage, to be a blessed marriage, everyone, then you must work on the foundation of that marriage. The Bible says, my people perish for lack of knowledge. We look down on foundational issues. Imagine, everybody coming here now, look at me, everybody in this church now admires all this and never admire the foundation. Nobody speaks about the foundation. Foundations are usually the first stage of any building or project. Foundations, no matter the plan God has for us, foundation is number one. Your foundation is number one. No matter this thing you see, this beautiful edifice of your church, if you had visited here when they were laying the foundation, it looks so ugly. No attraction. That is the first stage. Don't ever look down on the first stage of things you do. Don't ever look down on the beginning. For instance, I came in contact with this woman and a young man that wants to marry. What do I do with this woman from the first beginning? That is the foundation. That is the foundation. When I come in contact with this woman and I intend to marry, what I do with my first contact is called the marital foundation. The way I relate with her, the way I handle her, has to do with the foundation. If I don't raise a good foundation with this woman, no matter, even though we married and even though all the priests in the world gathered on the altar, you will hear the Bible say it. It's an 11. Foundation destroyed after the just man. So you, married man, what was the foundation of your marriage? Now you see how your marriage is dancing, my ghost, shaking. What was the foundation of your life as a young girl? The moment you are of reasoning power, age. You understood the life. What kind of foundation have you laid for yourself? This testimony, I have to be like, if you ask me to judge myself, I will tell you, I prayed more when I was preparing to be a priest now. When I was in the seminary, God was calling me, oh my God, every day I was shooting 48 decades of erosion. Without missing it, 48. Then it was only 15 decades we were having. I was finished the first 15 decades in the morning before they wake up. Ask your priest, one of my classmates, we have a philosopher and school. Ask him, let me tell you. When you said he went to seminary with me and met me in the seminary, tell you. And I taught, even today, I managed to pray all the busy schedule. I still judge myself based on my foundation. And I always think myself failure. I always think myself failure. Because my foundation, I have always desired more than what I'm doing now. No day without stations of the cross in my foundation. As it's in so when I'm angry, I go to my spirit and I tell myself, I'm not happy. I'm going back to say, Mary, you're not understanding. You have more work than you have. I said, no, I want to be like before. You have some of you have more foundations. Now, number four. Foundations are usually hidden, not seen. Nobody sees foundation. Nobody can see the foundation of this building. Sir, man, nobody should know and see your foundation unless you want that person to see them. They are hidden. So as you are now, your marriage may be going out with two children going, and nobody understands the foundation of that marriage. Some people married a woman who used satanic handkerchief to tie them. They don't know the foundation. Few years ago, we saw a church where they laid the foundation of the church, those who were in the social media. And you saw how they buried four healthy men on the foundation of the church building. So that after they have cemented them and raised the floor, as the human beings are rocking, becoming mukum, population will be in the church. They got there. They were exposed. Why did they bury human beings rather than foundation? Foundations are not seen. You see, we have faith in God matters. That is why I pray for everyone here, tonight and tomorrow night, that we shall be concluding this program. Everybody here, you shall be going home with a new foundation. Including Shabbat and the land. You don't know. You don't understand. In the book of Tobit, Sarah never knew she had a wrong foundation. There are some of them that have come to that. Let me give you these things to do about foundation. Number five. Error in any foundation can totally bring about destruction at any level. Error in any foundation, at any level, it may be when you are taking, it may be when you are finished building. You saw what happened in Dibie Joshua's church. Error in the structure brought about the collapse of the building after some time. It may take 10, it may take 2 years, it may take 5 years, it may take 20 years, but error in the foundation, if there's an error, if those who wanted to build your church or those who build your house, they did not build the cement and the granite and the sand very well, and they did not hold it, and you went and put heavy iron roof sheet on the people of the building. On this year, 1 year, I don't know the kind of music they are playing under your own now. I don't know why many of you, instead of enjoying your life now, you are shedding tears. In the book of Tobit, Sarah was not married. She had her own foundation. She never knew how Asmodeus entered her. As a young girl, something happened to her. I said, no, she got to maturity. She got to the age of becoming a beautiful damsel and God's wife. The foundation spoke and fought against her. I don't know what is fighting you. You'll be blaming your immediate boss in the office, blaming your neighbor, blaming your tenant, not knowing that your problem is foundational. And the devil is not going to be like you laughing. The Bible says that God planted good seed in you. You planted good seed in your children. You planted good seed in your business. And then he went out. Oh, the enemy came at night. Planted light. That is foundational light. Midnight farmers. You don't jump with them. They are busy working on your foundation. When they planted the seed, nobody knew. It was covered. Hidden. Seven men died because of the wrong foundation. Seven men died. There are many of you numbers here. Every man that breaks up place between his children. You're beautiful. You're beautiful. Sexy. Long hair. Beautiful lips. Balanced teeth. And at the end, anybody that dares. That was the condition of Sarah. Any man that came in contact with Sarah after the marriage, that night the man was dying. I've heard cases of father, pray for me. The man that wanted to marry me, this he came to my house, his business, pure. Many things can die, not only life, business can die, health can disappear, because they came in contact with you. In Psalm 11, presiding verse number 3. Foundation was destroyed. What can the just man do? God is aware that a just man can have a wrong foundation. You are holding today, since 10 years, you have never stolen, since 15 years, you don't go to Babalawo, so you attend money mass, you are a good charismatic member, you have done life business seminar, you have all the gift, you are a wonderful steward, oh, your voice can bring down angels automatically. But if you have a wrong foundation, my people perish for lack of knowledge. Truth will set you free. Truth is knowledge. And that's why I'm here. I'm not here to dance my first time with you. Let me tell you, friends, the very fact that I'm here, a lot of things are waiting for me to do when I go back. No space. No space. There is no time I go out that my phone is all hot. Why? Because of the plenty things on my head. Plenty. Even as I'm praying for you to die tomorrow, I'm asking God to increase my foundation. I'm telling you, God, my foundation is solid. You will see. Can you see? After yesterday's talk, I just told you, one of you came to meet me. Said, Father, we spoke about this medical center free of charge. I will draw the plan for you free. Is that not a question? I just told my. There are three persons now who have offered to draw the plan free. And then when you build the hospital, the thing that I need for the money. Who will you see the table now, boy? What can I say? You go, no, you go. Say, Lord, and worship God. This is my foundation.
This is my foundation.
Number 6. And for anything to stand, it must have foundation. For this thing to stand, there must be foundation. Sizzlers. You met her at a party. Every weekend you had a husband party. Every time kissing party. Party kissing party. For the first 6 months, you met that girl. No foundation. And then you say, I love her, because you put on blue film and lick your head, lick your bum bum, lick everywhere, celebrating as if this girl is wonderful. And on that ground, you marry her. On that ground, you marry her. Can you see the foundation of your marriage? And then, just let me tell you, don't be deceived. Those of you who are married and you have 4 kids to jump around you, and you have 1 Jeep and 1 Lexus for your wife, and then you have 1 good house in Lekki, and you have 1 in the village, and you have don't forget that donkey. Good shelter, good water, good food, but tight. 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 The worst thing that can happen to anybody is when you do not fulfill your destiny. When you are celebrating 50 million, but in the master plan of God, you are destined to be celebrating 50,000 billion. Sir, this is my own spirituality. God made me to know that there is regret in heaven. Regret in heaven. How? In heaven, regret? Yes, this is what my own personal revelation. My son, for a little, even though you think you will enter heaven, there is regret in heaven. How can there be regret in heaven? Come on, that you say, I am putting nonsense. But for me, it's not nonsense. Because when I die, or you die, and you go and meet God, and you enter heaven, no, no, no. And so you're welcome. Come, come, come. But there is one room that we must enter in heaven. That room is a room where there is cinema. Cinema. There's a cinema. A very big white wall where everybody's fire is. And when you enter the house, say, welcome, sit down, this is you. Bim, 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 bim. Now you cannot see your mother carrying you for the day. You cannot see you. That way you know that in spirituality, your eye is extra. You will see yourself in the womb of your mother. How you grew, your day of labor delivery, you will see yourself. I went to primary school, secondary school, your master plan. Lord, who is that one? It's you. Me? Me? This one? It's you. You mean? Okay. Having seven companies. You there? The village? You mean white men with something? But I didn't experience it on that. Why not? God will now stop your plan and rewind. And then take you to the foundational era where you slept with one witch. I say, since you slept with this witch, you followed another road. Thank God you are in heaven. But you missed. You will now say, oh, regret in heaven.
You mean I'm supposed to own 28 buildings and 10,000
information. One day, when Tobias came and married her, oh, that night, I enjoyed myself. I was there. I saw it! You know what? That one is very tricky. Many people today are living wasted life because the devil attacked them when they were young. Maybe you like prayer. He will use prayer here away from your foundation. Maybe you like food. He will use food and shoot you away from your foundation. Maybe you like singing. He will use singing and singing you away from your foundation. He knows what you like. And he knows how to try. If you don't have a father, you can never have a feather. You can never fly. Who is your father? Who is teaching you? Who is mentoring you? Anybody who does not have a father can never have a feather. You must have a spiritual director. Not befriending your director. Not having a director that comes to your house and you leave him stout and lying and you call your family friend. Somebody will tell the truth. Listen to me. Destroy our foundations by contact. When you have contact with a wrong person, with a bad content, your foundation can be damaged. When you come to a house of a witch and you proceed in eating the woman's food that she has invested with witchcraft, you have contact with this bad woman and the bad woman has a bad content, you are contaminated. Many testimonies have been written because the fear that you know ego in man is a wicked people. Now what are the signs? How do you know if you have a dangerous or funny foundation? Number one, short life, you die. Premature death in the family. You see, in this family, they die. Let's ask your father and your mother, what is happening? Have you been burying people in your family anyhow? Have you been losing younger ones? Short life of even what you are doing. Short life. Your business begins. Yeah, your relationship begins. The relationship that should lead into marriage because you have a wrong foundation. Let me tell you, friends, there's what we call spiritual foundation. Apart from physical or psychological or psychosomatic foundation. Some of you here now, your foundation has been tested from the point of view of your emotion. And this man is This is me. That's the trouble of your emotion. There's time not to cry. When you are crying, you're not supposed to cry, you are stupid. Short life. A marriage of 3 years problem. It's zero in the foundation. A business that had a good beginning, the seed fell on the ground, and the sun came and destroyed the wrong foundation. Do it like a seed that is sown. Some we fall on rocky ground, some we fall on ordinary sand, some we fall on tongues. God was describing different foundations. Only one is good among the four. The solid foundation, the fertile soil. When you invest 50 billion on the wrong foundation, it will collapse. Number two, you know that you have evil foundation when you embark on what I call profitless hard work. Profitless hard work. You are doing hard work, no profit. You work, no profit. You suffer from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. Profitless hard work. There are some people the devil will deceive. You know, when I was very young, when we travel and we are traveling, you see a river along the express. I said, oh, you see a river? I just pass you, you see the river again. Mirage. Devil is with that money, presenting all kinds of substance around you. Tell you, this is what you are doing is the best thing. Do it for you. Go, move, go. Check how many years you have devoted to nonsense. Profitless hard work. Number three, endlessness. As you are now, there is no
You don't have direction. You don't even understand where you are going to. You are singing, Sarah, Sarah, whatever I live in, I lie. That is not a good song for a Christian. Sarah, Sarah, what maybe, maybe. Fold your hand and let you follow your demo. The devil made you sluggish. The time you act, the devil made you sluggish. Number four, sickness that defy medical diagnosis is a sign of foundational error. This person is your son, sick, sick. And look, same many of them. You see that some of them, their parents took them to a river. They bought whiskey in the river when you were very small. Let me ask you a question. If you wake up and realize that there is a mark on your body, mark on your forehead, mark on your chest, on your breast, on your head, please try to know why. If you don't know why, step into the realm of faith. Move to the realm of faith if your father has died and died. If your father cannot do it, your father here can do it. That's why you have a father. We have two families, physical family and spiritual family. And the spiritual family is higher than the spiritual family. Even your own father calls me father. That is why church, Okamaka, church good. Hey, life is not meant for those who lack foundation. In making spiritual progress is one of the signs of evil foundation. You cannot move. There's something holding you. Stronghold and strong man holding you. You want to go. You back. You want to go. You keep recovering. Constant failure at the edge of breakthrough. You have stories of God. The time that who wants to help you will help you, the time that he wants to help you will go sick. Your brother will promise to help you. When you say come, that day you will go in here, they want to go out. Number one, why must you express constant and consistent disappointment? You can count, if I give you a paper that you write, you can write more than 58 disappointments you have experienced in life. And they are not minor disappointments, they are major ones. Major ones. The day your father wanted to give you money for school fees, he died. And then you didn't go to school again. He said, make sure that if you sit down and examine your mind, you will realize that a lot of this happened. How many of you have actually prayed concerning your foundation? Show me your hand. Let me three verses about foundation. Let me warn you now. Don't be very stupid to believe this issue about family liberation, liberation. How to break your head now? What are you liberating? Family, 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 family. You keep collecting money from people. And if you have one family liberation for more than 6 times, different prayer group, from mountain of fire, from charismatic, that sister in the law, that brother in the law. If the family liberation is working, why are you still looking for someone who has family liberation? Foundation, take your own. You, as an individual, you are important. Stop cursing your family. You are a tree. You can single yourself out. And when you say that you have family liberation, your uncle is against it. Your brother is against it. You have me by force. No one mind. Why not get it yourself? Why not sit on yourself up in baptism? Baptism is the breaking of evil foundation. The foundation that we have built on Adam and Eve, wrong foundation, destroy the foundation, the devil mess on the foundation, and through baptism, you are separated from that foundation, that atomic foundation, you are placed on the other foundation of Christ. You don't know how to do this in the same day. When you go away,
If I'm waiting for all the priests to follow my revelation, I will be in trouble. I will follow it, and by the grace of God, many are following me. So don't be killing yourself, fighting with your uncle, fighting with your auntie, fighting with your grandpa that is in the grave or mortuary. Follow you. You are destined to be great. You, forget about my sister, my brother. You. Work on your foundation. Build your foundation well. After tomorrow, I want to let you know that by His grace, we all here will be having a new foundation. Telling you the truth.
Amen.
I believe in instant miracles, but that is not where it lies. Change of life, righteousness, peace, and joy is the kingdom of God. Righteousness, peace, joy in the Holy Ghost. Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. That's the kingdom of God. Don't you want to be a part of the kingdom? Don't you want to be a part of the kingdom? Don't you want to be a part of the kingdom? Come on!
Come on, everybody!
That is it! What is righteousness? Right where I'm living! Sir, it is not each of us sin or no sin. You need to understand the right way to the edge of breakthrough. Constant failure at the edge of breakthrough. Take it from me, friends in Christ. When you have error in your foundation, people will naturally hate you. Being hated for no reason. You can't understand why they hate you. You have not met this man before. From the very day you hate him. You can't explain this. This is an error in foundation. You lack favor. Every child of God is supposed to enjoy favor. I just came here yesterday. I must stay 24 hours. Favor don't hit me. I'm a child of God. That song is valid if your house is built on Christ the Son of God. If you dare to be a bad day, that is what is happening in of us. Let me tell you, friends. Everybody comes here and desires the beauty of your church. Nobody is celebrating the foundation. You celebrate the marble, the window, the lighting system, the air conditioner. Please, how many people here have celebrated the foundation? More often than not, we don't understand the theory and the spirituality of foundation. But if you do, you will never in any way live a misguided life again. You have your life. You want to celebrate your wedding when you have already roofed the house of wedding? You are inviting bishop, inviting priest for your wedding. When that your marriage has reached roofing stage. You won't go together on my wedding day. But God knew. You know, God made a woman, Jesus, tell woman, your husband. He said, no, yeah, because you have 7, it's fine. Who are you? Before you call on me to come and bless your house that you built, what happened there? Woman of hearts. The bishop will come and book will come. Can't you see how you need to drink back to your house? The only foundation is there. Your mind tells you that after building, they can bless the foundation. Solve it for you. Because you break it down. Don't do anything. God, that is why it's good to have spiritual directives. God knows you give envelope and you are happy. Your mind tells you that I give you envelope all the time, I'm going to heaven. You are flying to heaven. So many people claim to be Christians when they are not Christians in the church. Cosmetic Christians. In the line they worship God because they are rich, we follow them. We go to many parishes, we preach follow the rich people. We respect because they are making things so move. And
are not regarded. There are people doing what they don't see. People who are walking in the foundation of the church. I tell you suddenly, the secret of Father Dibie's ministry is those who have been praying for me not to fall. They are seriously holding in prayer all these old village mamas that after celebrating ministry, my offer change is 10,000. That God do 200 naira, 20 naira. I still receive 5 naira in my church. I still receive it. If you finish ministry and you want me to give you change of 10,000 naira, I will give it to you free. You can hardly count how many 500 naira notes in my husband. And the ministry program in the village. But God is gracious. From the village, I've done so much. From the village, I have the first Catholic TV station. From the village, I have an orphanage home. From the village, we have psychiatric home. From the village, we have worship from our school. From the village, we have some school. From the village, we have. What have you to do? I'm ending now. It is time for you to examine yourself and ask yourself some questions. How can your business prosper when there's an error in your foundation? Why you examine your master? You may be the 75,000 in an account. You may take your master's money as a young boy, saving it in an account. You serve your master for 3 years. You save almost half a million naira because you have the intention that when you begin your own, you will not have big money. That is a wrong foundation. You are not married the girl. The girl sleeps with you like wife. The man sleeps with you like wife. Anyhow, no conscience. It will have to work again. Neighboring no. What do not like that? When you now begin, you see problem. Problem. That is why we are not hungry. That is why we are limited. That is why you are not happy. Let me tell you now, let me surprise you now. Almost all of us here, 80% of us are average people and poor people. Almost all of us here, who believe in God? The rich people that you want to be like, who don't even have time for God, but they have evidence. They don't have time for you. Baby, they lack of us. How do I carry on? They laugh us. When you see your friends living in the society, the kind of perfume, the kind of megas they call when you have changed my income. You see the kind of cars a young beautiful dancer is cruising. You see the kind of house where it's becoming so difficult for them to know if there's what they call maturity, because even everything is automatic. They don't want to call it. When they press one button, toilet will disappear. They don't press one button, pandemic in his house. But you and I, we are busy eating it. And we claim we know. No, what? No, what? I remember 3 years when God was calling me from this one, 1994-5. I said, God, if you really want to use me, don't make me a beggar. Covenant with God is faithful. Because it is, and it, for instance, when the Reverend Father, maybe it's a new parish priest in your parish. And he celebrates mass and prays and there are, and you do that. And then after about 2 months, you are not God's man. You have money, the father heard about you, and you're a parishioner. And the father now comes and asks, oh, good morning, sir. How are you? Yes, man. They told me how you have been helping the church. He said, please come to help you. My fire is not in good shape. Even our fathers are, who do you go away now? The man will just enter the room and say, I said they must come, he must come. Hey! And you go inside and tell
1 million. That. And take your tax a party pot. Shake it, shake it. Oh, Father, what am I to do? Let me know. How much is the fire? Father, fire? Anyway, I will change the car for you. But take this 1 million. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. On that foundation. All through his years in that parish. Half of. But he may not know. So it's not only for you, it's also for us. You went and slept with Maryhill.
At a village called Umoji. And Umoji, there's one festival they call Uzui Festival. So I was invited there and we were praying. That was this charismatic at Umoji there, they were vibrant. Now they're 2000. And I was there as a young vibrant prince. Boom, boom, boom. And then suddenly, bam, there was manifestations on the ground. Bam. And then after some time, the charismatic prayer was there, Father, come. And I was jumping like marble. I was very young. Jumping like butterfly. I never knew that it was a stupid energy. I'm supposed to do the thing well. I'm a church man. I'm using you as a pointer. I can see your eyes. So, do that to me. And the one who this beautiful girl, she was talking. What she was saying attracted the charismatic brothers, and I was with you. She was saying something that attracted them, and then it needed my attention. And I go there, she was saying something, I had to put in my phone in front of my mouth to hear. And everybody had a Christian girl, and that's who would you? Emeka, Goretevi, John, Goretevi, Peter, Goretevi, Chukwu, Goretevi, Devi, Goretevi, Chukwu, Goretevi, 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 Goretevi. Your name is John, praise God. And that is the first name I mentioned, John Goretevi. Amen. To call this consolation, I personally became attracted to what you are saying. This is a foundational issue. I'm coming to that. So you understand what I mean. And the prayer became very intense. And by the grace of God, this lady was delivered. And when she got upon this and she was talking and giving testimony. And what was her testimony? Here it is. As a beautiful young girl. There is no man that will see that girl that will not look at her twice. Even like your Reverend Father. You will thank God for her life. She's so beautiful. This girl was initiated. Sometimes you don't know how you're initiated. It's a hidden thing. And they don't expose foundation. Many of you that may have been tied somewhere without knowing, they don't expose it. No witch. One woman doesn't know that it's a witch. And what happened? This girl, there's a state around her house. When the mount of this thing in her private house, according to her, any man that makes love to her, releases his sperm into the mouth of the snake. That in that room where she was initiated, there's a big pot like that one they used cooking rice with 3 legs. It was hid there. The snake pours all the sperm there. And any man, no matter your level, if they succeed in putting your sperm there, your life will be like this. No happiness of this. According to her. So that when the fire of God came, mightily, she had a mother in religion. And she said, yes, Emeka, come, and I did it. Very much today, we have to go back home and the next 5 minutes, I want to yes, there was no way in the seminary. How about the mighty man? very church. Go to this very church. A few are from home. A few more. The Pope was here. So, I don't listen to them. They now brought the film to the seminar. We call something like this. I got a story. And the street comes to me. The film was about a young boy in the village. And this boy in the village was pursuing one small girl. And one day, the girl went to the river to fetch water, and the boy was hanging by the bush. And as soon as the girl came, he pushed the girl, the calabash fell. These epic stories. And then pushed the girl to the bush and raped the girl. And then the girl came out with the field, they showed blood on her leg, and he cursed the boy and said, whatever his father's catch, I deal with you. At that point in time, the boy was just a young boy in the village. Not as we were a young boy in the village. Ladies and gentlemen, this boy never knew his destiny. Do you know what happened to those who are watching him? The boy ended up entering the seminary. Became a seminarian. And because he was called to be a priest, he became a priest. But the foundation gets with him as a priest. Any woman will say, vroom. Until this man slept with Peter Doche's daughter. Yeah. Peter Doche was a vice pastoral pastor. You know he likes that kind of thing.
Yeah.
Hey! Get him up! And they reported him to the bishop, the Pope. They called the Pope, the bishop. And he got to the Pope, and the priest was sanctioned. Sent to the monastery. He was there crying. You need to watch this movie. All time movie. The Pope was here. Just look for it. You will understand what I mean by foundational errors. The Pope, and he cried and cried until after some time, they now sent a monsignor to go and pray for him. It was a monsignor now who got there. The priest confessed, was so sorry, and God prayed for him and broke the yoke. Yoke is foundational terminology. If the yoke is not broken, you cannot be free. After that, the bishop who then became Pope reinstated him and sent him to one rural village to begin again. Ladies and gentlemen, when he got there, the devil knew what he would be. This man transformed the parish spiritually. When he lifts up his hand, demons will run. People started rushing to that village. The ministry started in the village. Devils, witches, and wizards, couples scattered. The name of the priest spread around in the village and beyond. People started tripping to that village. They were shunning to touch his garments. The one that priest had committed fornication many years ago to come and touch them. Everybody ran after the priest. The priest was touching them, laying hands on them. They were receiving their healing, receiving their breakthrough. There was transformation, there was revival, and the church became so powerful. The devil knew and visited him when he was very young. Some of you here, please, I permit you to go back to your history. Check your life. Did you steal somebody's goats when you were young? Did you eat somebody's chicken? Did you steal somebody's pints in the hostel and they were placing curses and you refused to own them? Stand on your feet. Did you curse your father? Did you curse your mother? Did the mother curse you before he died? Did your father curse before he died? Did your father or mother take you to a shrine? And they did something to you? Were you dedicated to a river? Were you always sick when you were young? And your parents took you to a place? And they did all they did? And today here you are. Your parents never knew that that fever was an attack. With beautiful destiny, you are suffering. With sophisticated destiny, you are in pains. The foundation was destroyed when you were young. So lift up your hands, friends, in Christ. And I offer these few prayers, and I will prepare for tomorrow. Every evil done to your foundation today, I destroy the energy power.
expectation card. Because I know you are reading some things there, and I know after today you write more. Lift it up and then see what's on
choice. You are crying in the name of Jesus. Don't do suffering, poverty, because there's an error in your foundation. You cannot hold money. You are so weak to hold money. By the power of this altar, I pray for you. That evil that is kept in your financial foundation, I destroy it.
A child sleeping and they are beating you and slapping you. I pray for you that if you can shout a loud amen, your foundation will wake up. I don't know you. I don't know if there's anyone here who really wants to see me.